Does taking BCAAs help with your muscle gains, fat loss, or ego in the gym? Or are they simply a waste of money? While these types of supplements generally are perceived as positive additions to one's diet and training regime, they may be something that you might want to rethink the next time you begin to hand over your hard-earned money. Branched-chain amino acids, or BCAAs, are a popular supplement in the health and fitness realm. But if you're a little confused and you're wondering what an amino acid even is, let's break that down first. Amino acids are the building blocks of life. If we didn't have these guys, then, well, we wouldn't exist. You see, as proteins are made up of amino acids, if we didn't have these amino acids up for grabs, we wouldn't have protein. Then we wouldn't have muscles, organs, various other tissue in our body, and our body would not even be able to carry out numerous processes like digestion and even muscle building. So there are 20 amino acids, with a 21st being discovered recently. Of these 21 amino acids, 9 of them are termed essential. These 9 essential amino acids, or EAAs, are held at a high regard because our body cannot manufacture them. Instead, we must consume them via our diet if we hope to maximize our body's building and maintenance processes. If you take a close look at these amino acids, you can see that they all contain the same core design. This is more commonly referred to as the amino acids backbone. On closer inspection, you can see that all of the amino acids contain what is known as a carboxyl group, an amino group, and only differ in their R group side chains. Tryptophan here has what is known as an indole group attached to the amino acid backbone, whereas leucine, for example, only has 2 methyl groups attached to the carbon 3. These differences in the molecule are crucial to tell them apart, and of course for their different effects and possibilities. How amino acids do their thing is simple. They combine with one another via peptide bonds to form proteins. To see this easier, let's break tryptophan's carboxyl group and leucine's amino group up into their truer formations. Now that we have those hydrogens separated, all it takes is for us to push these 2 amino acids closer, and the carboxyl group forms the peptide bond with the amino group, and then expels a water molecule. Now when we look at the newly combined formation, we can still see the main tryptophan portion of the molecule, and the leucine, and of course here's the peptide bond. Amino acids essentially go through this type of process until they form enough bonds to make a protein. Proteins then go on to be used for things like cell structure, cell functioning, enzyme synthesis, muscle synthesis, hormone synthesis, recovery, various metabolic pathways, and even for optimal immunity. Inside your typical BCAA supplement, you will find 3 of these EAAs: valine, leucine, and isoleucine. Valine, leucine, and isoleucine, when found together, provide people with what they're all chasing: muscle protein synthesis, aka dem muscle gains, bro. In this story, however, leucine is the main protagonist. If you took him out of the picture, then the movie fails to do well at the box office. Too metaphorical? Look at it this way. If leucine is not consumed alongside these other 2 amino acids, then the other 2 essentially shut down. What this means is that the effects that you're most likely chasing, like building or maintaining muscle, become diminished. What you can do to ensure that this doesn't occur is simply consume the other 2 alongside it. But this is where it becomes a little hazy. You see, while taking these 3 amino acids does ensure the benefits that people may seek, for truly optimal results, all 9 of the EAAs must be consumed. Which means simply taking in the 3 that are found in BCAA supplements may be a waste of time and or money. Furthermore, protein-rich foods like chicken and eggs contain all the EAAs at high amounts. Which brings us to our main question. In a study by Glynn et al., it was found that a mere 1.8 grams of leucine is enough to induce a maximal muscle protein anabolic response. Moreover, in a study by Katsanos et al., it was found that roughly 3 grams of leucine is enough to improve muscle protein retention and reverse a lack of stimulation of muscle protein synthesis. So it seems, in short, between 1.8 and 3 grams of leucine is enough to provide people with the benefits that they typically seek when taking in BCAAs. Any more and their body simply has no use of them and will expel them. As typical BCAA supplements on the market today contain roughly 1 to 2 grams per amino acid per serving, requirements can be met in a single serving of that shaker bottle you probably haven't washed properly in a while. However, let's say that you're serious about your health. And let's therefore assume that you eat sufficient protein already from real foods throughout your day-to-day life. Then you're more than likely already eating your requirements. For example, if you consumed a mere 100 grams of chicken breast alone, you would take in over 1,000 milligrams of valine, 1,700 milligrams of leucine, and 1,200 milligrams of isoleucine. Think about it, that is from less chicken than what people would typically consume in the course of an entire day. And if the same people also happen to consume 2 eggs throughout the course of the same day, then they would also gain roughly 300 milligrams of valine, 700 milligrams of leucine, and 400 milligrams of isoleucine. What this means is that practically everyone that eats an adequate intake of all the macronutrients will already gain the required amounts of these three EAAs, meaning drinking BCAAs simply means that they're drinking expensive water. Since most of us that care about our health are already eating enough dietary protein, it immediately becomes realized that buying this type of supplement is somewhat unnecessary. Instead, if you do happen to desire some form of liquid in and around your workout, perhaps you may be better suited to simply drinking whey protein variants. These can be far more satiating and satisfying as they contain extra nutrients that can provide you with far more benefit than the three lonely amino acids. But hey, let's say that you love your BCAAs. If we want to be positive about them, then there is indeed merit regarding the fact that you just simply love the taste of them and that they help you focus and train better. There's nothing wrong with either of those reasons, especially since it is your money after all. Of course, placebo may play a role somewhere here too, but this may now be void after watching this type of video. So, what to do then? It's simple really. Eat enough of your protein requirements through food and you can reap the rewards that you seek. If you think that you need to have some sort of liquid before, during or after your workout, then opt for whey and save some serious cash. Nothing beats food. And if you are serious about your health and fitness, then you will more than likely already be consuming enough of these bad boys from your diet alone. Therefore, meaning that there is no need to rely on this type of supplement. Hey guys, what's going on? I'm Hayden and I hope you enjoyed that video. If you did happen to learn something from it, please make sure you hit that like and or share button. That'll really help me just to kind of gauge whether or not to keep making these types of videos. If you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you hit that subscribe button. That'll really help me out. And every bit of material that I used in the construction of this episode will just be linked in the description. So if you want to learn a little bit more about anything, just make sure you follow those links. I guess that's it. So thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.